Sports coverage of the NFL finds us at Bank of America Stadium in Uptown Charlotte. Just a few moments ago, this building was shaking as the Carolina Panthers emerge from the tunnel here in Charlotte. They are ready to go as the Panthers are set to match up with Derek Carr and the Las Vegas Raiders. That'll be taken about a yard deep. And he'll be brought down at the 28-yard line, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone gets him three more.
Take over first and 10 at their own 28-yard line.
Carr now on first down. That ball's caught. Aguilar right side. And he will lose yardage and be backed up to the 24. Not what they had in mind there. That's going to go as a loss of four. So they had the big loss on that first down pass play and facing a second and long. Shotgun now for Carr. He'll let this go deep for Ruggs. And there's the first NFL catch for Henry Ruggs. And he's going to get this deep on a Carolina side of the field.
A gain of 59.
Well, partner, that's how you make a long drive suddenly not so long anymore. One big play, and they're already in field goal range with designs on getting more than that.
A real field flipper there as all of a sudden they've got a first down in the red zone. And this is intercepted, but they'll say out of bounds. So very close to a turnover there in the end zone.
Henry Ruggs, the rookie, his intended target.
And that'll bring up second down. And effective running here. He'll take it down inside the 10. 9 yards, not quite enough, and they'll be left now with third and one. Trying to run for it with Jacobs. And he's able to pick up the first before he's brought down inside the 5 at the 4. He was 4 yards on the play, and that leads to the first and goal. Here's Jacobs. And he's in. Touchdown, Raiders. Taking it in from 4 yards out. And the Raiders drive right down the field and score on the opening drive. Excellent start there. First drive of the season. Big time success putting it in the end zone.
And remember, that was done without any real map of how to do it. In other words, the deeper you get into the season, you get game film to work off of, tendencies to work off of. The first drive of the season, things can be entirely different than what you've seen in the past. It's a really good job of execution by them.
And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line.
25-yard line.
Bridgewater going to lead the Panthers up here, first and 10 at their 25-yard line.
First carry for Christian McCaffrey. And he's going to be dropped following a pickup of 7, past the 30 to the 32.
He's tackled at the...
A nice run here early on. It doesn't take a great play call to realize you want to establish a guy of his caliber who runs like this early, because they'll pay dividends as the game progresses.
On second down, McCaffrey. The good run on first down followed up by a not-so-good run on second down.
Now let's find out if they're going to stick with the run here on third down. A lot of people would love to see some play action here. I say go with your best running play over your best blocker.
They'll try and pick it up with McCaffrey. And that one going nowhere from the start as he's met in the backfield and goes backwards. He lost 2 and it brings up 4th.
A loss of 2 yards. It's 4th down.
Oh, a big decision here early. Look at this. They're going to go for it on their own side of the field. They're indeed going for it. Bridgewater. Trying to get it to Thomas, and it's intercepted. Jonathan Abram picks it, and the return will be stopped at the 34-yard line. So, CD, his very first pass of the afternoon intercepted.
And I know that's a major surprise for any quarterback because, look, let's face it, no one thinks about throwing interceptions. But think about all the warm-up that we saw, right? Every pass he threw wasn't a single interception because, oh, that's right, there were no defenders out there. A little bit different when there's live guys out there chasing the football.
They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And the Raiders are going to have a first and goal as some good running there gets them down to about the 2-yard line. Knock it on the door. It'll be a pickup of 8 and a good first step there with second and goal coming up. They'll run it with Jacobs. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. A second down play results in a loss of 2 yards. Third and goal. And now the ball's out. Carr lost it. Fumble. And it's picked up by the Panthers. And he'll return it to the 24-yard line.
Well, give some credit to the defense. They forced the big play, knocked the ball free from him, but that's a cardinal sin by the quarterback. Know where you are on the field, and he just gave up at a minimum 3 points.
And instead of getting down, takes the contact. The turnover ensues. And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39. Right after the turnover, they come out throwing.
And that means it's a sudden change situation. We used to practice it on defense. Sudden change, get out there, stop the offense. But you typically run out there a little bit unsettled. I think that's why he came right out throwing the football, hoping to catch him off balance.
And he did. And able to rip off a big chunk of yardage before being dropped inside the 40. 22 more yards there and another first down.
39-yard line.
So again from the 39, this time from the other side of the field. Here's first and 10. Bridgewater, a play fake to McCaffrey. He'll look to throw. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down. I know he wants to get his team back in the game, but a 50-50 ball right there that maybe was a little questionable.
Yeah, he's pretty lucky to get that one back. I think that sometimes his quarterbacks play with a lot of confidence that borders on arrogance, and that can put your team in some dutch.
Yeah, especially maybe you want to look at some safer routes after the interception he had that ended their last drive. Now some movement before the snap. And we'll hear from our referee for the first time this afternoon. So after the penalty, heading in the wrong direction, second and 15. And again, it's Bridgewater. They'll set up the screen to McCaffrey. And he'll go down here at the 35-yard line.
For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass. Looked like it was coming together. Looked like there was an opening. Still, ended up with a solid game.
The Raider defense strong on that one in coverage, and now it's fourth.
They really had a good drive going there, but a nice recovery by the defense these past few downs. Able to knock that one away on third down and bring up what I think for the offense, an unexpected fourth down here.
Now remember, they were unsuccessful earlier in this first quarter. Going for it on fourth, they're going to try a second time. Into a double team, and it's intercepted. LaMarcus Joyner with a pick. And he will take it across midfield and down to the 45. First quarter, and now he already has two interceptions.
Yeah, he's got to guard against being tentative from this point forward, though. He's got to still make the right reads, make the proper throws. I've seen guys in this league throw four interceptions in a game and win. He's got to understand, put it behind you, keep pressing forward.
And he'll look downfield for Waller. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Dante Jackson picks it, and a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
The Panthers take over first and 10 at their own 11-yard line.
This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. To this point, the results have not been good. Two possessions, two turnovers.
And that's obviously something that can't continue, but to go a little bit deeper on that, I would think about some play calls now, not even necessarily to my best player, but to someone I can trust with the ball. Try and get things settled down a little bit.
Bridgewater on first down. That's going to be caught by Samuel. Not much there, only a yard.
To Curtis Samuel. A gain of a yard. Brings up second and 9 at the 24-yard line.
After 1-7-0, on EA Sports.
Raiders 7, Panthers nothing.
Throwing again on second down, Bridgewater. Now they set up the screen. That's complete. And up to the 35 before they're able to knock him down. 11 yards there. First down.
First and 10 at the 35-yard line.
Now whistles. Flag down, and I believe one of the Panthers got moving early. A full start backs him up 5. First and 15. Out of the gun, Bridgewater. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. They'll contain him to just 4. Second down.
At the 35-yard line.
From the shotgun to McCaffrey. They'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets them up for third down. So from second and long, now we go to third and very manageable.
Yeah, they love that phrase, don't they? Because as an offensive coordinator, you can keep people a little bit off balance and guessing because you don't have to throw it. You can come back with a strong run game if you want to. And if you're in four down territory, that really opens things up for you.
The defense surrenders a 13-yard pass play there on third and one. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Bridgewater throwing complete here to Moore. And he'll get him down after a pickup of 8, second and 2. A good pickup there, 8 yards on the first down completion.
At the Raiders' 35-yard line.
Now a draw play to McCaffrey. And that didn't fool anybody. He's going to be dropped to the backfield.
This defense has really flown around in the first half. They've gotten to the ball carrier before they can really get started. Offense going to have to come up with something else in order to try and get this running game going.
Third down, here's McCaffrey. And he's going to have the first down yardage as he's down at about the 30-yard line. 5 yards is the pickup there as that extends his drive.
At the 30-yard line.
So first and 10 now from the 30. From the shotgun, it's Bridgewater. Escaping the pressure right. And now he's going to use his legs. He'll get 8 on the scramble there. It'll be second and a couple.
While you admire anyone trying to pick up an additional couple of yards, they're just not worth it when you take shots like that. Quarterbacks have to stay in the game and stay on the field.
And he'll only get a yard to bring up third and one.
And this is why aggressive defense coordinators love to blitz. It wreaks havoc because they end up taking their attention to the blitzers, freed up the D linemen to make the play.
On third and one, here's Bridgewater. Got his target, Samuel. And brought down, but not before they get it inside the 10 to the 7. A first red zone opportunity for the Panthers thus far. They've got it first and goal at the 7. From the gun, Bridgewater. And he will take it across for a Panthers touchdown. A 7-yard touchdown grab. And the Panthers are now an extra point away from tying up this game. And he'll bang that one through.
That ties the game at 7.
So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. Taken in the end zone. And he'll just take a seat and the drive will begin at the 25-yard line.
At their own 25-yard line.
The Raider offense set to get this drive started. They had the interception last drive, led to the tying touchdown. So 7-7 the score as they begin first and 10. Reception here by Ruggs. And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion. Here's a second and 2 now from the 33.
Second and 2.
From the gun, it's Carr. Flushed out right. And he's got the hook up to Ruggs. Jukes by it, and he will score. Touchdown, Las Vegas. Henry Ruggs with his first career touchdown in his first career game. And the Raiders have taken the lead. And he's got it. It's now a 14-7 ball game.
Raiders 14, Panthers 7.
Following the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Carlson. That'll be taken about a yard deep. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23.
The Panthers take over first and 10. At their own.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. Good drive last time. Really effective passing the football. Do you maybe mix it up, now go to the ground game and surprise the defense a little bit?
I would anticipate the defense making some changes, but I wouldn't necessarily just absolutely go in the opposite direction. They're doing so well throwing the ball.
Yeah, well,
I wouldn't change it up until they showed me a reason to do so.
And they're able to get this one across the 35. Give them 14 on that one and a first down.
And there's Christian McCaffrey with another run. Run CMC, as he's known in the Carolina area. Easily the most productive running back in the league last season. 2,392 yards from scrimmage. He's just so dangerous every time he gets the football. Whether you hand it to him, throw it to him out of the backfield, just imagine if they had the guts to let him return kicks as well. This guy is a true triple threat.
And he'll get it into enemy territory just across midfield at the 49. Now the Panthers going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. On first and 10, Bridgewater steps away to his left. He's going to take off with it, and he'll go down inside the 45 before going out of bounds. He'll get five out of the scramble. It's second down.
It's a gain of five. Brings up second and five.
They'll try to throw here now, Bridgewater. And that is incomplete. Robbie Anderson, the man he was looking for. And it's third and five.
To this point, I've been impressed with the work defensively. They have not allowed a lot of receivers to run free. And there's another example, another incompletion.
They'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. And he gets it to the 34. Good enough for the first. 9 yards on the pickup there, and it keeps the drive alive. The Panthers going to use the second of their timeout as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. From the 34 now, here's first and 10. Throwing, Bridgewater. Oh, he's going to let this go for the end zone. He's got it for a Panther touchdown. Robbie Anderson, 34 yards. And the Panthers are now an extra point away from tying up this game. And a little time left on the clock, so on the other side, they're thinking, gosh, we'd like to get that lead right back.
Yeah, thanks for pointing that out. Here I am going ahead and tapping out the first half. There's still time. They've got to make a decision about what they want to do on the kickoff, where they want to let their return guy touch it.
This one tied at 14 now as he sends this one away. And this will not be brought out. It's a touchback.
At their own 25-yard line.
The Raider offense set to get this drive started. And we're under a minute to go here. What's been an even first half, all tied up.
Yeah, still time to make something happen, too. Couple completions, you string them together. Could get into field goal range. Let's see what happens.
And he gets this up just shy of the 30 to the 29 before he's out of bounds. They'll contain him to just four. Second down.
It's now second and six.
Working from the gun, it's Carr. He'll let this go deep for Ruggs. And is this intercepted? It is. It's intercepted. Picked up by the rookie Jeremy Chin. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. And he may want to track down that football because that's interception number one on his career.
You're saying that's going into the trophy case?
I'd put it there.
Yeah, no doubt about it. That's when you ask the equipment guys to make sure they hold it for you after the game. Playing the back seven on defense, that's part of your job, finding ways to take the ball away from the other team.
Now the Panthers going to signal for their third and final timeout as they'll stop it with a little over 30 seconds to go in the first half of play. Throwing the out route and complete. That's Thomas. And he's able to get this one up to his 30 before he's out of bounds. Well, we looked at each other right away. We knew that flag was coming out.
And I always enjoy the conversation post because officials always tell you, I don't want to throw the flag, but you caused the play. You did it. I had to.
And he was hit as he threw it there, and it forces it incomplete.
Certainly appeared to take away his first read, and by the time he tried to look elsewhere and find an open target, the coverage was too good. That one falls incomplete.
Short throw to the tight end, Thomas. They do get a yard there, but only a yard. Leaves them with third and nine looming. So we've reached halftime here on opening weekend. As we'll send you down the coast now to Orlando, that's where we find Jonathan Coachman, ready with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
To kick off for Las Vegas.
We'll see if week one fatigue becomes any kind of a factor as we are back underway in the second half. That'll be taken about a yard deep. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback.
The Panthers take over first and 10.
This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. And both of these defenses have been stifling these last few drives offensively. Just not able to get anything going, so what needs to change?
I think a lot of the guys will go back and review, so to speak, because everyone has someone assigned to how did each play work. Okay, what did we use that kind of worked for us during this game? Try and get back to some of those plays, as well as the possibility of showing something you haven't shown already in this game and trying to change things up.
We'll see if they take the advice of Mr. Davis. Third down, Bridgewater. Oh, and Bridgewater intercepted for the third time. LaMarcus Joyner with a pick, and they'll set up shop in enemy territory at the 45-yard line. Now after the INT, it's Carr. Throw left side complete. It's Jacobs. That catch good for only a couple.
Caught that look from you there, partner. I think we're on the same page on that one. Just his first catch. I think we both thought he'd be a little more active in the passing game. Let's see if that's the start of them trying to get the ball to him a little bit more here in the second half.
Carr with a play fake to Jacobs. He'll get this one complete to Zay Jones. And he takes this just a few yards shy of the red zone before going out. 19 yards to pick up there. Move the chains.
And the Raider first down.
This is caught by Winton, the tight end. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard.
It's a gain of 9. Brings up
on second down. It's Jacobs. And he is in. Touchdown, Raiders. Josh Jacobs. Already his second touchdown here this opening weekend. And the Raiders have moved out in front. He's given him a little jolt, just gave him the lead there, but two TDs now in the game.
And that jolt puts them in the lead. What a terrific job by him. He is carrying the ball and simply saying, I want to win.
And now he's hoping his defense has that mentality as they try to hang on to that lead. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get this up to the 29.
The Panthers take over first and 10. Their own
the Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. They'll look for a drive to tie this up down 21-14 as they have it first and 10. He works his way forward for a couple up past the 30. The last run got a couple here, second and 8. They stay on the ground. McCaffrey again.
I think we can safely say that those types of players are the backbone of this offense. We know not every run's going to be a big hitter, but you know they'll take that type of result on each and every attempt.
Third and 3.
Third and short yardage, Bridgewater. And a flag comes in as that one falls incomplete. Well, let's see who this is on. Now, if you're going to get rid of it, you better get outside the pocket.
Yeah, you have to get outside of that tackle-to-tackle box, right? Get out there, and then you can do it legally. But he wasn't able to do so, and they end up losing the down as well.
Here's Michael Pilardi now. And surprisingly, this is the first punt of the game for either team. So a change of possession here on the punt. And the Raiders will take over now first and 10. They'll begin on the ground with Jacobs. And he'll have a gain of 3 to the 33.
The Raider ball carrier.
Yeah, I don't know if it's exactly a win-win, but if you're on offense, you'll take that kind of a run, all right? It was kind of stacked up, found a little bit of yardage, and frankly, they're pretty close to staying on schedule on offense. The playbook is still open for the coordinator.
They'll stay on the ground with Jacobs. taken down, but not before he works it past the 50.
I thought when Josh Jacobs was coming out of the University of Alabama, he was an absolutely perfect fit for John Gruden's offense with the Raiders, and it turned out, in this case, I was absolutely right. Led the NFL rookies in rushing a year ago, 1,150 yards. In fact, the only rookie to top the 1,000-yard barrier, and this kid is a workhorse who can carry the football in any situation and catch it out of the backfield.
Second and 10, third quarter of the season opener. Carr able to find Ruggs. That's complete. 9 yards, and that leaves him just short, so it'll be third and less than a yard.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you've got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go, because he might wander into some tough coverage.
And he's able to get the first before he's taken down at the 36. A third down gain of 3 yards, and that'll be enough. So from the 36 now, first and 10.
Brandon, they're still in the lead, but momentum's certainly been going the opposite direction. So to me, that's a really important pickup there on third down.
Try and regain some confidence, and you're right. They need to stem the tide a little bit. That certainly helped. This pass from Carr taken in by Waller. And they'll be inside the 35 now at the 34-yard line. 3 yards the gain there, second down.
Seven at the 34-yard line.
Shotgun now for Carr. Flush to his right. And he's going to keep it here. Carr can beat you in a lot of ways. The scramble there, a perfect example as he gets the first.
A gain of seven. First down, Las Vegas.
Here's Jenkins on first and 10. And not much of a hole there as he gets it down to about the 24-yard line. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
A gain of two. Brings up second and eight at the Panthers' 24-yard line.
Operating from the gun, Carr. He'll get this underneath to Jacobs. It's a gain of five on the play, and they're going to face a third down.
That might feel like a little bit of a lost opportunity there for the offense, because the defense brought pressure that time. And sometimes against that, you can get out to your running back, and it could turn into a big gain downfield. But what a nice job they did getting to him quickly and holding him to a short gain.
And he'll head out of bounds inside the 10, mark him down at the 9. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. Back to the running game with Jacobs. And he'll be stopped just outside the 5 at the 6. It's a gain of a couple, and it'll be second and goal.
A pickup of 2. Brings up second and goal.
Second down and goal. Carr. This is caught. And he is in. Touchdown, Raiders. From 6 yards away. And the Raiders add on to their lead. Circle that drive, because that might be one to remember. Well executed to give them a little cushion.
Well, let's take it into the boxing ring. You talk about them commanding it, keeping the fight where they wanted to, whether it was in the center of the ring or putting them on the ropes, because it was jab, jab, jab. And finally, the haymaker to put that drive away.
And taken down just past the 20 at about the 21-yard line.
Take over first and 10.
This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. And we're back now in Charlotte. It's the Panthers in possession of the football, but facing a deficit here as we get to the fourth and final quarter play. Oh, look at Thomas, wide open. And he's able to get this to the 40-yard line before he's out of bounds. It's another first down on what will be a gain of 21 yards. So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's first and 10. Here's a pass swung out left to his running back. And he's taken down inside the 30. 11 more on that one, and another first down.
Carolina Panther.
Bridgewater, a play fake to McCaffrey. He'll look to throw. Floating one, incomplete.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
Here's second and 10 now from the 29. To the air again with Bridgewater. His throw caught right around the 6. And he gets it all the way down inside the 10 and mark him at the 5. They'll try to run with McCaffrey. And the Panthers are going to have a first and goal. It's some good running there. Gets him down to about the 2-yard line. Knock it on the door. Give him 4 on the carry there. It's second and goal.
A 4-yard gain. Brings up second
from the 2 now. Second and goal. Bridgewater now. Fighting for the end zone. He lost the football. It's out. And he'll take this into the end zone. Touchdown, Carolina. Taking it in from 2 yards out. And the Panthers are able to get this back within a touchdown. Extra point splits the uprights. And now things get a bit more interesting here in this fourth quarter. This game back within a touchdown now as the kickoff's away. And that one bounces out of the back of the end zone, so we'll start the drive at the 25 on the touchback. The Raider offense set to get this drive started. They've been rolling the last couple of drives, each ending in touchdowns, so this game is flipped. They were down, now they're up with the football. We'll see how they handle it.
Can we get a spy on the headset now between the head coach and offensive coordinator? Because they've been in attack mode, had to get back into the game. Now they have the lead. Do you stay on the attack, or do you dial it back a little bit to try and protect this lead?
Well, my cop-out answer would be somewhere in the middle. I think it's going to be a fine line, is it not?
I think you're exactly right, but I do think if they can stay aggressive and keep them on their heels, they'll be best served that way.
15 yards on the play, first down.
Las Vegas, first down.
From the gun, Carr. He'll let this go deep for Ruggs. And that's going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down.
Finally, a good play there defensively on the deep ball. The secondary has had its struggles this entire game. Offensively, they've had their way with them.
On second down, Jacobs. And he gets this one to midfield before he's brought down. 11 yards there, first down. No doubt those are the types of carries they're looking for here, Charles. The lead in the fourth quarter. This is when coaches that have a reliable running game, they breathe a little easier on the sideline.
Yeah, they love the idea that they can take the air out of the football at this point of the game. That means they're really counting on that offensive line, counting on the runners, taking care of the football. Because you're going to tell your quarterback, hey, no time to be a hero. We're not going to throw it here. Just eat up that clock. And if you have the ball, they can't score.
And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. No gain on the play, and now they're faced with a third and one.
And it's third down.
Here we go, third and one. Gut check time on both sides. Carr going to give it to Jacobs. And he will have a first down here at about the 40. It'll be a pickup of just 2, and the Raiders are going to get a new set of downs. Just week 1, but already plenty of intrigue with the games going on, and this one no different as we come up on a first and 10. And I think this defense knew what was coming as he is smothered behind the line. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11. If nothing else, they've already taken a couple minutes off the clock here already as they come up second down. Now they'll throw with Carr. This complete left side to Aguilar. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Raider touchdown. Third touchdown pass now for Derek Carr. And the Raiders able to extend that advantage. And that is the definition of yards after catch. They go short on the pass, and the receiver does the rest.
Seems so harmless, doesn't it? To throw it underneath, short pass like that. But boy, it gets dangerous in the hands of the right receiver as he makes a move and takes it the distance.
Following the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Carlson. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully.
The Panthers take over first and 10.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And they'll be looking to build off of a nice drive last time, a drive that really relied on the quarterback.
Making good decisions, distributing the ball well, distributing it accurately, keeping it away from danger. A really nicely run drive.
But now the defense, what adjustments do they need to make in the passing game?
Pass rush, pass rush, pass rush. Whether it's the guys up front, or maybe you bring additional guys, but you've got to disrupt the timing of them throwing the football.
We'll see if they can disrupt it here. The Panthers on third down. They've hit 4 of 7. This is 3rd and 10. And he comes back with one complete. And he is going to have a Panthers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. First catch of the new season for him, and he picks up the first.
2-yard line.
So it's Panther football as we welcome you back. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. Now a desperation throw deep down. And that's caught inside the 30. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. A gain of 32 that time.
At the 26-yard line.
Play action now. Bridgewater. And this is caught now for a late touchdown. So hold everything here. This one's not over yet. Okay, game on. Don't go anywhere yet. You got a one-score game now. Probably going to rely on the onside kick coming up.
Yeah, they have to. It's not a high percentage play, but it's better than not having a chance at all. And that's when you put your leapers and your flyers on one side, get that high hop, and hope that one of the guys can come up with it.
And on the other side, get that hands team ready.
No doubt about it.
And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Raider offense set to get this drive started. And this game not quite over yet. And we'll likely see them take all three timeouts defensively, so they can't just kneel this one out. They're going to have to try to run a few plays.
You're exactly right. They've got to get a first down and make them use up all their timeouts in order to feel like they have this one in hand.
At the 27-yard line.
Once again, it's Jacobs. And down right around the 32-yard line, 4 yards on the pickup. The Panthers going to use the second of their timeouts as they'll talk it over here before what will be an important third down. To throw his car. Yeah, that one going to be knocked away and incomplete.
How about some applause for the defense there? They forced him to throw that one into coverage, and just like that, they're staring at a fourth down. Well done.
Here's A.J. Cole now as he's on a punt for the first time this afternoon. They'll call it a punt of 44 yards. The return was for 7. And the Panthers will take over now, 1st and 10.
At their own 28-yard line.
This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. They're down here in a one-score game. But the time, it's a factor, but it's not a huge factor right now, is it?
It's really not, because...
And, oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Jonathan Abram picks it. Oh, he's got some breathing room. And he takes this one back into the end zone, and the Raider defense delivers a score.
What you just saw there, first-round talent, second year, even more success. A pick six for a touchdown.
A great play. And it's tough for these guys, you've told me before, to adjust in the secondary as a first-year guy. So that sophomore season, it's big for them.
They really start to expand the playbook for them even more. Sometimes they dumb it down a little bit to make them comfortable year one. By year two, they should have all the nuances. And now they've adjusted to the speed of NFL play as well.
Showed right there. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback.
At their own 25-yard line.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. Back to it after the pick six. Bridgewater. Eluding the pressure right. And they're able to get this one across the 35. Nothing open downfield. He keeps it himself for 11 and a first down. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Jonathan Abram picks it. Yes, folks, that is his third interception, and I'm going to use one of the most overused phrases in football. He's a ball-hawking safety.
I love the way that you called for the shot there. That's perfect, though, because There is something to that. Being a safety often allows you freedom to roam around a defense, maybe not a specific assignment. Today, his assignment, find the football, and he's done so quite well.
Today's final score.
So this one, a victory for the Las Vegas Raiders. And with that, our journey begins, Charles. Week one in the books. Going to be a great season.
Oh, man, so much to look forward to. Isn't it nice to get a really good game right out of the gate? Preseason behind us. All these games count now, don't they?
Yeah, this is the exciting time with just 1 week gone and plenty of weeks to come. So for Las Vegas, hey, you get a win, you get it on the road. You can't ask for much more than that to start the year. And they'll return home next week to take on the New Orleans Saints. Meanwhile, for the Panthers, they obviously fall to 0-1 with the defeat. And they'll try to get back on the beam next week as they'll head to Tampa to take on the Bucs. And for Charles Davis and our entire crew, I'm Brandon Gauden. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports.